YouTube, and welcome to the first episode of Ask Mizuki Fester. In a nutshell, this series is going to be about you guys asking me questions. The questions don't have to be about anything in particular, doesn't have to be about gaming, doesn't even have to be about me. It could be you asking for advice for something that's going on in your life, or something stupid. You could just ask me a stupid question and I'll answer it. So yeah, anyway, let's get right into episode one. Okay, my first question is something I can't read without my glasses, which you guys have never seen me in before. So yeah, I'm gonna like read my question now. My first question is, where did you get the name MizukiFester? Well, honestly, it's not a very interesting story. When I was in school, me and Georgette used to go and hang around with our friends in town. We used to go in town and hang out with quite a few mates. There was quite a lot of us. And everybody except Georgette, because she's a loner, was making nicknames for themselves. So I picked Mizuki, and sometime later I found out that it meant beautiful moon, and I thought that was pretty cool, so I kept it as Mizuki. And then Fester was a word that randomly made me laugh a bit, so, and I randomly found out it sounded pretty cool on the end of Mizuki, and 666, I just added that because it's the devil's number and I am a devil. Yeah. So yeah, basically, I thought it was pretty cool, and yeah. Ever since then, I've been using it for basically everything, every username I've ever had, and my gamer tag, obviously. So yeah, that's the reason behind MizukiFester. So that is my first question covered. And again, I can't read. Well, I can read, just without these, it's difficult. Sort of dirty, that's really annoying. My second question is, how old are you? I'm 17 and I will be 18 in January, so before you're just like, you was too young to be doing Call of Duties. Yes I am, but not for too much longer. My third question, what is your favourite movie, TV show of all time? Well, I have to say, my favourite movie of all time is Predator. For the simple fact that when Arnie rips off Predator's mask and goes, "You one ugly motherfucker," it's amazing. It's so funny. It's a great film with an awesome storyline and awesome characters and awesome guns and action and stuff. My favourite TV program is Family Guy. It's crazy how they can get away with saying half the stuff they do on TV. That's most likely why I like it. It's a bit out there and not everybody likes it because it's a bit crude. And yeah, they do say some pretty horrid stuff there, but it's awesome. My fourth question is, who or what inspired you to start making YouTube commentaries? Gameplay videos. Originally, I was inspired by making money from gaming, but that was originally. I'd watched loads of commentators, and one video that one guy made really stuck out to me. It was a video by XJaws, and it was about how to make how to make a successful YouTube channel and team and stuff like that. And I got me thinking about what would happen if I started making videos. And another reason was to show you guys how much bullshit a lot of us girl gamers get when they join a game. So I was basically brought here because of temptation, got here and was inspired by you guys and wanted to tell you guys all the stuffs that goes on in my life and stuff. So question five is, who is your favourite YouTube commentator? as I just said, I've watched a lot of commentators on Machinima and just general commentators on YouTube. And to be quite honest, a lot of them on Machinima don't deserve to be there because they don't take it seriously and they just go around slandering a lot of people. So yeah, I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys will agree that right now Machinima isn't picking the best people to be commentators. That isn't my question. But yeah. One that does deserve to be there, and that is awesome, and I will watch till the day I die, or when he stops posting, is C-Nanners. The reason I love C-Nanners so much is because he's just so casual. He's just like, I don't know, he's just too awesome. Everything he says makes me laugh, like exploding penises and such like. Question number 6 is, what got you started playing video games? And it all started when I was about 4 years old, and I was best friends with this girl who lived down the road from me. She had a brother, an older brother, who had a Sega Mega Drive. And we would constantly bug this guy so we could play on his Sega and go on Sonic. So it basically took off from there, and her brother got an N64 and got Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time, and I would sit in his room and bug him, and he'd be like, get out my room, and I'd be like, no, and I'd watch him play Legend of Zelda. I'd sit there for ages and ages just watching him play this game. And then I asked my mum for a Nintendo for Christmas and Legend of Zelda, and I fucking got it, and I was damn happy. That one game started all this. If it wasn't for Legend of Zelda and it wasn't for me falling in love for that game and getting so frustrated with that fucking game, I probably wouldn't be here commentating and playing Xbox and stuff. So yeah, Legend of Zelda started all this. Hello guys, magic jacket. Question number 7. If you could meet any one person, who would it be? There's a lot of people that would be pretty cool to meet. Since I have to pick one person, I'd love to meet my favourite guitarist, John Petrucci, get some good old guitar lessons and shake his manly guitarist hand. Question 9 is, where do you want to be in 10 years? Wow. In 10 years I'll be 27. Holy shit. Fucking hell, 27, that's crazy. By that time I guess I'd want to be living in my own house, because let's be honest, who wants to be living at home with your mum when you're 27? Probably nobody. But yeah, I do want to be living in my own place, with a well-paid job that preferably I enjoy doing. And let's face another truth, people. It's not very often you get a job doing something you actually enjoy, is it? But yeah, basically, I want to have made something of myself and be able to stand on my own 2 feet. And that's what I want to do and where I want to be in 10 years. Question number 10 is, what do you want to do in the future? Well, at the minute, I'm not in a mainstream college, but the college I am in is working towards putting me in mainstream college. So when I do finally get there, I want to go and do some media studies or something to do with computers. I don't know how far in the future you mean, to be honest, so I want to do something amazing, like wrestle a shark, or maybe just buy a nice car or something. Question 11. Do you think that you'll play games for the rest of your life? Looking into my crystal ball, I see myself playing video games till I'm like 85, crippled in a rocking chair on some fucking sick futuristic console, like killing noobs and shit. So conclusion, yes I do think I'll be playing games for the rest of my life. Question 12 is, what is your favourite game from your childhood? You probably think I already answered this in another question back there, but you are wrong, sir! or madam. I had a few favourites from when I was little. Banjo-Kazooie being one, Ocarina of Time another, Quake was definitely one of my favourites, but it scared the shit out of me when I was like, I don't know, 4. But when I was that age, I never really bothered completing any of the games I had. I just have fun with it and play around. Didn't complete Ocarina of Time until I was like 14. Didn't particularly bother doing any of that stuff, so yeah, they were my few favourites from when I was little. Question 13 is, what is your fondest memory of gaming? When I got my Xbox 360 last year, just seeing it coming out of that box, knowing that my Call of Duty adventures were just beginning. I joke. My best memory of gaming was when I got my first dogs on Black Ops. It was the best gaming moment in my life. And when me and Georgette played Black Ops for the first time together, that was amazing, because she didn't get Black Ops for like 2 or 3 months after I did, and I was just so bored playing it on my own, and then she turned up and I was on the dashboard and I was like, Georgette's on Call of Duty Black Ops, invite to game, and yeah. They were my fondest memories of gaming. Question 14. If you could be any video game character, who would you be and why? Oh my god, this is the best question ever. And I would be Link, but like Linkette or something. So fucking badass. Walking around with the Master Sword in his hand, just like boom, and his massive fucking shield. Battling through the night and into the morning. Slapping spiders in the face and almost getting raped by Gorons, and yeah, what other reasons could you have to want to be Link? I mean, he's awesome. Yeah, that's who I'd want to be. Question 15 is, what do you want to do before you die? Well, seeing as I'm only 17, never really thought about it. I want to travel around the world and go on every roller coaster, except the ones that are made out of wood and don't look sturdy enough. And I want to have enough money to buy an Aston Martin or a Ferrari one day, just to say I can. I guess I just want to enjoy my life before I die. Question 16, what is your favourite genre of music? Nowadays I don't really have a favourite genre of music. If you'd asked this about 2.5 years ago, I would have turned around and said, I don't listen to anything but metal. And I would have just been like, yeah, in your face. But now, it's really different. I don't really have one particular type of music. I like to listen to everything. I like pretty much every type of music. Question 17 is, what is the most said thing to you as a girl gamer when you join a party or game? Well, it doesn't vary a lot, let me tell you that. It's usually along the lines of, get back to the kitchen, or what the fuck is a girl doing on card? Or, you're not a girl, you're just a faggot 12-year-old pretending. Basically just things along those lines, like insults, you're not a girl, get off fucking Xbox, get in the kitchen, things like that. Question 18. Has anybody ever told you that you are gorgeous? Not recently, but in the past, yes they have. Question 19. How did you get to know that beast, BK Random? Oh my god. For viewers that aren't BK Random, fast forward the clip to the next question. Because this guy sucks for asking how we know each other. Basically, BK Random, I got to know you through a couple of friends, and I used to be a dick to you because I could, and I was just a bitch anyway. And then we started hanging out, and I realised you weren't a bad guy, and why was I being such a dick? And then we were friends. Ta-da! Jazz hands! Question 20. Am I asking too many questions? What? What? It's a fucking questions and answer series. You're meant to ask questions. No. No, you're not. Well then, YouTube, there's only one thing left to say, and that is thank you for watching my first episode of hopefully many to come of my Q&A series. So, yeah, you've got another week to post me 20 questions, people. Otherwise, there will not be another one of these, and I will not be like blah 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 about the stuff that you want to know. So, yeah, remember, it doesn't have to be about me. It doesn't have to be about gaming. It doesn't have to be about my videos, my channel. It could be something to do with you and your life. You might want my opinion or some advice or something. So, yeah, let me know, and there'll be another episode next week. Thanks for watching.